Hello, we will start in a few minutes. We are just waiting for everyone to get connected. It would be great if you can share with us in the Q&A space where you're from, where you're visiting from. Well, welcome everybody. We will start in a few minutes. We are just waiting for everyone to get connected. It will be great if you can share with us where you're visiting from in the Q&A space. Thank you very much for waiting. We are almost going to get started. Thank you for being here. We already saw that we have some people from Mexico, from Russia. Thank you very much for sharing. It is great to be here, and we will get started in a few minutes. We also have some people from Guadalajara, from Nigeria, from Spain. Thank you very much for sharing. It's great to be here together today. We will start in a few minutes.
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. We are very happy to be with you today. I am Patricia Villanueva from Avalon International School in Mexico City. I am going to introduce you to Alejandra Navarro, our presenter today. She was born in Mexico City. She has been working in education for 21 years, first as an English teacher, then as an academic coordinator and principal. She has a bachelor's degree in veterinary medicine and animal production, and another one in preschool education. She has several IB certifications, as well as others in emotional health, conscious discipline, autistic spectrum disorder, and some others in the English language proficiency. She has been a PYP coordinator for the International Bachelorette Organization for 6 years and an English coordinator for 5. Currently, she is a principal of preschool in Avalon International School. Please, if you have any questions, write them in the Q&A space and we'll get to them at the end of the presentation. Thank you and enjoy our presentation. Thank you, Ale.
Hello, everyone. Sorry about that. We are very excited to be here with you today. We also feel a great responsibility because we know we are representing teachers and schools from around the world. And even if we don't have the same situation in every country and every city, we are very glad to contribute with some strategies and resources that have been helpful for us. Today we are going to talk a little bit about how to improve our social emotion learning using e-learning with our kids. Let's get started. What have our children lost in this pandemic? started? And the answer could be focused on the academic part. But if we really think about it, there are different answers for this question. For example, playtime with peers, working in teams during class, teacher-student approach, solving conflicts in everyday situations with friends, follow-up in class, having simultaneous activities in the classroom with different classmates and different teachers, one-on-one work with a teacher, the psychologist, the therapist, not going to school, and social isolation provokes stress and anxiety in children, especially in teenagers. How can all this affect our children's learning? Well, definitely it will. It will affect our children's learning because we need to remember that the emotional part is very important. And if their emotional part is not well, their learning ability will be affected. We also need to think that each family is facing a different situation. And we need to take that into account as well. We need to make sure that our children's emotional part and their learning has a balance. So let's stop a little bit here and let's reflect on this question. What are we doing to help them overcome this situation? Each of us, from where we're standing, think about what you are doing to help children overcome this situation. And well, e-learning, of course, right now is the only way that children are getting involved with school. So using resources, digital resources, is imperative. We need to find them and use them. This makes learning attractive and engaging for our children. And opposite to what some of us could think, we don't need a great financial investment for this, because a lot of these resources are free. And the ones that are not, the services providers are open and willing to collaborate with schools in order to make this work. So don't be afraid and look for these resources. I want to share with you some of the platforms we have been using and that have been very effective for us. For example, Achieve 3000, No Red Ink, Matific, Classroom, Seesaw, Books, Desafío Leer. And well, I want to talk to you a little bit about them because it's very interesting how, for example, in Achieve 3000, the kids get a test at the beginning, so they will get their level. And after that, the teacher can approach the same topic with all her students, but each one in their level. So they will get the same title of the selection, but on different levels, depending on when they where they are at that moment, as well as the questions they will get. They are also leveled. Matific is a resource where you can work math concepts with the kids, and they use a lot of games. So supposedly a bunch of monsters got lost in this world, and the children's mission is find them. So they are going to get some challenges, and when they accomplish them, they will start getting back their monsters cards. And at the end, well, they will have to bring all of the monsters back together. So it's really fun for them and they really enjoy it. And they really don't feel they are working with math at the moment. So I really recommend it. Well, Classroom platform, probably a lot of you use it nowadays. It is great for monitoring the children's work because the teachers can create their own class and they will assign everything they want the kids to present or to bring back to her. That is also a very good tool for evaluation and of course to have this follow-up with the students. And Seesaw is more or less the same as Classroom, but it works for younger children. because they can upload their, they can make drawings, they can upload their pictures, they can even record their own voice talking about their evidences, and it's great. They can write their name or label what they want to do, and they are able to get feedback from teacher, from their parents, and also from other classmates. So they really love this one. Desafío Leer is a resource that is in Spanish, but it's also for working reading with the kids. And also the teacher can create her own class, and she will be able to be tracking the children's reading, how much time they are spending there, and how many books they are reading, the type of books they are reading, and also have some comprehension activities for them. And books is also a reading resource, but it's also for small children, for young children. It is great because there are a lot of stories, but it is very interactive. There are videos, and the characters are really great. So these are just some of the platforms and the resources that we would recommend for you. Now, it doesn't matter if the resources are for free or if they are paid. All of these platforms have different benefits. They bring us or give us a lot of benefits. For example, teachers can have a differentiated teaching because of what we said about the levels. Each kid can have the level he or she needs for her process. They can also meet international standards. If that's what you're looking for, a lot of these platforms work with international standards. The teachers can have the students follow up just as they used to have it when they were back in school. Some of these platforms are inquiry based, and they stimulate children's curiosity and the inquiry, of course. Teachers are able to approach different global topics with their students, and all of them are engaging and very fun for the kids. Now, let's remember that children don't come to school only for academic purposes. They come also for social and emotional support. We have to remember this at all times. And we must assure them that they are not alone. I am certain that all of you have strategies for this purpose, but we would like to share some of the ones that we have because they have been very successful in our school. Morning ceremonies. These all-together ceremonies are great because children are able to see other people that they don't usually see in their normal classes. So they can see kids from other groups, they can see teachers from different levels. They really love this because they can remember their community, even if they are not in touch as they were before. Teachers include fun activities in their classes. And here, well, they can do whatever they can think of. They can include cooking, arts and crafts, games. Anything that comes to your mind would be great. Because remember that when kids are excited, it's when they can learn better. So if you are playing with them or doing these type of activities, they are not going to be working, or they are not going to feel that they are working. They are playing, but they are also learning. So this is very important to include. Teamwork. And teachers should plan teamwork in every week. This could be challenging because, of course, the distance, but we have been working with the Zoom platform, with the break rooms. It is a great tool because teacher can have her class and then she can divide the kids into small groups. She can be visiting each of these groups and she can guide them, she can explain to them, or just be with them for a while to see what they're talking about or what they're saying. And then at the end, she can bring everybody back into the plenary. 1 to 5 sessions. We have 1 to 5 sessions every week for every child. These sessions are small groups, and the teacher is going to organize these sessions or these groups depending on the objective on the objective for that week. So, for example, one week she's going to explain something again, or maybe she's going to practice something with them, or maybe she's going to give them emotional support, or maybe a game, anything. Any ideas, she can carry them out here in these 1 to 5 sessions. Also every week, our kids have a special class called Emotions Workshop. This workshop is given by our psychologist, and it is a class where there are a lot of games and fun activities, but the purpose of this is that children identify and accept and manage their emotions. In these activities, because they don't feel them, because they are also having fun and playing, sometimes they even share their emotions with the rest of the group. We have also implemented this strategy of Star of the Week. Probably some of you already know it or have heard about it. This is a great activity. We love it because it helps us to know our children and their families better. And the way we do it is like this. The child that is chosen to be the Star of the Week on Mondays will share information with us. He or she can make a poster, bring some pictures, whatever, and will share information about their family, friends, likes, dislikes, hobbies, pets, anything they want. On Tuesdays, they present their favorite toy or their favorite object. They can talk about it, who gave it to them, why it is their favorite, anything they want to share. On Wednesdays, their parents write a letter to the class talking about their son or their daughter. And this is really, really cool because they usually write beautiful things about their kids. And sometimes they even make us cry because of the words they use and all the things they write. On Thursday, this kid will get a positive comment from every classmate and teacher. And on Fridays, he or she is able to invite a guest to the class. When we were back in school, this guest had to be someone their same age and will spend the day with us in school. But now, it can be anyone. They can be family members, friends from other schools, or even people from other countries. And this is, I think, another great benefit from e-learning, because now they can have anyone they want in their class. This activity makes children feel appreciated and loved. Also, our kids have this emotional support anytime when they need it. And we also have an inclusion support program, which supports kids with special needs or learning disabilities by making curriculum adjustments, following up during classes, one-on-one virtual sessions with them, and communication with external therapists where they collaborate with each other in order to achieve the goals that are proposed for each case. We also have this emotional aid for anyone in the community if it is needed. Now, I think we will all agree when saying that parents or caregivers have been always an important part in children's education. But I think now this role has become essential. A lot of them are feeling overwhelmed because of all the help and support they are having to give to their children. And at this point is when schools become aware of the importance of building community. For us in Avalon International School, parents have always been an indispensable part. They become involved in several activities, for example, special celebrations, school for parents, our green school and recycling program, our school's orchard, among others. They also actively participate in workshops, lectures. They even come in as experts to talk to children in their classes about different topics, so they can share with them their expertise and enrich our units of inquiry, which is great. Okay, another important thing here is that we all know each other well, and this creates a sense of belonging, which it is transmitted to our children. So it is very important that we give emotional support to the families, that we listen to their fears, to their situations they are having, and to find spaces to accompany them. We usually recommend some strategies for our families, and we also want to share that with you, what we tell the parents that they can do with their children. And that would be, the first one is, try to stay positive. Be careful of your actions. Take care of your words. And pay attention of what your children are watching and listening to in the media. Spend some time alone with each of your children. Sometimes we know this is difficult because we don't have a lot of time or spare time, but it doesn't have to be much. It could be 20 minutes a week that you spend with each one of your sons or your daughters, where you can do different activities. It doesn't matter. The important thing is that no matter the age, you need to listen to them and have your full attention in each one. Create everyday routines. For children, routines are very important. If they already know what is going to happen, their anxiety levels will go down. So make sure that you have a schedule and that you include not only the mandatory activities, make sure to include also the recreational ones. Try to stay calm when there's bad behavior. Sometimes this is not so easy, but if you talk to your kids in advance, when they are calm, when nothing is happening, you make agreements with them, they already know the rules and even the consequences. If they already know the consequences for their actions, it would be easier for them to manage their emotions or their behavior. Now, when something happens, it is important that the consequence is there. Be realistic with the consequences. And when your child already achieved that consequence or already accomplished it, it is important that you recognize it. And then when everybody is calm again, talk about the issue. Talk to your children about their fears and emotions. Be there for them. Listen to their questions. Answer their questions. And if you don't have the answer, find them together. Okay, so we said that building a community is very important, but not only a local one. Nowadays, it is important that our kids get involved in the global community and that they take actions to collaborate with it. In our units of inquiry, students are able to know and explore different perspectives and to connect the learned concepts with their own experiences. Through our students' profile and our Avalon School Way, we help students to develop an international mindedness and an inclusive cultural understanding so that they become global citizens. It is important that children get to know, understand, and respect other cultures as well as their own. We plan specific activities to make kids aware of concepts such as diversity, inclusion, equity, discrimination, sustainability, etc. And through some learning experiences, students take action to propose possible solutions for different global issues. We develop skills in them to become active agents and to make positive changes in the world. Remember, our children now will be our future leaders. Now, we must not forget our teachers. We need to work together with them, to accompany them, make sure they feel self-confident and that they have all the resources and tools to work with our kids. We need to support them by giving them training, different resources and strategies in order to plan their classes. We also want to share with you some of the training that we have been giving our teachers and that we think it would be useful for you too. For example, flip classroom strategies. This is great for the e-learning. So be an inquirer and try to learn a little bit more about this because I think this could really help you a lot. Evaluation. It is important that we know that evaluation has to change. So how we are going to change evaluation? How is evaluation going to help us through all this that we are living right now? Class routines. It's important that teachers make sure that their class have specific routines. For example, always starting with a greeting. A different greeting can be a fun greeting, any kind of greeting, but it's important that they start with that. Having a warm-up, it's when they are going to connect with their kids, when kids are going to get involved in the lesson. Then the class development, and at the end, of course, the wrap-up. It is always important to include the reflection part so that we can develop in our children the metacognition. Positive discipline, setting limits, making agreements with the children, the same as we said in parents earlier, the same with teachers. Make your agreements in advance. Make sure your children know the consequences for their actions. What is allowed in the virtual class? What is not allowed? This is important so that everybody will respect them. Of course, digital platforms and resources. If we are going to use a resource, we need our teachers to know it. They know to really understand how it functions, the functioning, so that they can really use it with the kids. And always make sure to have some sessions of collaborative planning. Give teachers the opportunity to carry on with their professional development, but by making a personal training plan for each one. We should not forget to also give them a space where they can share their emotions, their fears, their inquiries. All of this will help our teachers feel fulfilled and appreciated. Okay, so let's make a stop here and remember these five key steps that are the ones that we have been sharing with you and that we hope that you could implement in your schools. So the first one is effective and innovative e-learning can be implemented in any school or home that has an internet connection. Remember, don't be afraid, look for them, use them. It would be great for the kids. Number two, make certain that our students are supported emotionally and socially when e-learning is the only trusted pedagogy at this time. Remember, not only our kids, when we support also their families, their caregivers, the teachers, we are also working with the kids. It takes a village to to raise a child. That's number three. Remember, building community is important. Work in a collaborative way with parents and with teachers. We are all in the same path. We all have the same objective. So work together. Number four, provide enhanced opportunities for students to connect with the global community. Plan strategies, plan experiences where children can take an active part and to give proposals for solutions in global issues. And number five, help teachers become more proficient at implementing strategies and resources in their classroom. Remember, teachers are an essential part of all this. Now we want to share a video that we prepared for you. We hope you like it.
I did my best to notice when the call came down the line. Up to the platform of surrender, I was brought, but I was kind. Sometimes I get nervous when I see an open door. Close your eyes, clear your heart. Cut the cord. Are we human? Or are we dancer? My sign is vital. My hands are cold. Looking for the answer. Are we human? Or are we dancer? Pay my respects to grace and virtue. Send my condolences to good. Give my regards to soul and romance. They always did the best they could. And so long to devotion. You taught me everything I know. Wave goodbye. Wish me well. You gotta let me go. Are we human?
Sorry about that. We had a technological problem here, but hold on just a second, please. Well, this usually happens to all of us, including teachers, so we are very empathic with you. Let's see if this can continue. Well, we are going to, we really wanted you to share with this video with you, but well, it will be available probably later in the recording. But well, this video was, at the end, we said thank you very much to all the teachers because they are making this happen, and it's, we know it's not easy, but we are with you, and we appreciate a lot what you do and all your work. So, well, our focus is the social emotional part of our students. Keep in mind that to achieve that balance with them, we also need to think of the well-being of the people around them, that are parents, caregivers, and teachers. We need to be empathic and to think of them as well. If they are in a good emotional state, certainly they will transmit that to our children. We are all role models for kids. Actions have more impact than words. We should never forget that. We hope all this that we shared with you may contribute to make e-learning a little bit easier, but most of all, that you all become aware of the importance of social emotional learning in children, especially during these current times. We know we are far from each other, but today we felt a little closer to you all. Thank you very much for listening. And well, we will see if we have any questions here that we could answer. Okay, we have here some questions. All of the kids spend time with school psychologists all together or one-to-one? Well, it depends on the situation. This emotions workshop that we have is for all the kids together. I mean, for all the group together. Each group has a session with our psychologist where it's this workshop. And then if there is a child that needs support one-on-one, the psychologist will have this one-to-one session with him or with his family if it's necessary. What kind of activities does a psychologist do with the kids from preschool? Well, I think preschool is a great age because you can do anything and they will be very happy. He sings songs with him because he also knows how to play the guitar. So it's great because he sings with them. Sometimes they make drawings. He tells them stories. He shows them some videos, and then they will talk about the emotions involved in that story or in that video that they saw or they watched. Okay, what methodology do we use? We are part of the IB, so our methodology is an inquiry-based methodology, and we are constructivists. Well, here we have greetings from Kenya. The workshop has been quite informational, and surely we can learn a thing or two from this. God bless you all. Could you share the PowerPoint presentation? Of course, we will make sure you get the PowerPoint presentation and the video because we really want you to watch our video. Okay. We have another one here. Congratulations. Thank you, Vikas, for congratulating us. Okay, here we have Glory from Nigeria. Thank you very much. Carlos from Guadalajara, a junior high teacher. Okay, so when children start growing up, it's more challenging. So great. Thank you for being here. From Sarajevo, Bosnia and Herzegovina. Belma, thank you very much for being here. A lot from Mexico. Thank you very much. From the UK. Thank you, Kirsten. Do you practice one platform for the school or different according to the teacher's desire? Well, we try, the teachers have this freedom of using different resources. When they already know how to use them, it's great. We encourage them to do it. But there are some platforms that we do use as an institution, for example, Classroom. We use it, all teachers use it from third grade up. and we use CISO from second grade down. We use Achieve 3000, for example, from all elementary and junior high. And we also use Matific the same for elementary and for elementary school only. In preschool, we have books and, well, any other resources that the teachers can find. So yeah, they have the freedom to do it as long as they know how to use them, of course. The platforms you said, can we get them in other parts of the world? Yes, of course. I am sure that these digital resources, I'm sure you can get them from wherever you are. If it's for free, I think it's easier. If it's a pay resource, probably you should contact the provider and they will tell you if it is available in your country. Can children talk about their emotions in 1-to-5 activity? Yes, of course. We encourage children to talk about their emotions every day and anytime. But yes, the teacher may organize that specific session to work something for the emotional part. Yeah, they, of course, they can do it. Okay, thank you. We have some nice comments here. Positive and emotional week. Good ideas. Thank you. Well, I think that those are the questions that we have right now. I think those are the questions that we have. What devices do they use at school? Okay, well, usually when we are in school, we have iPads and we have also some Chromebooks. But I think now at home, it is what they can have. Because as we said, each family has a different situation and we need to be empathic with them. So probably there will be families that have, I don't know, one device and two children, or maybe each child has a device, we don't know. But usually the resources that we use can be implemented in computers, cell phones, iPads, tablets, or whatever. So I don't think that would be a problem. Do the social emotional part implemented in the lessons classes as well, or just when the child needs it? No, we are always thinking about the emotional and the social part, because as we said, we need to have a balance. So we usually, in all the lessons and all the classes, we are working with emotions all the time. And when we see that a child or a family needs extra support, then we will plan a special session for them where we can talk about it and have some agreements and see how we can help them. Thank you very much. Some of you are congratulating us. Blanca, thank you. And well, I think those are all the questions that we have here. Thank you so much, all of you, for being here today. It was a pleasure, and we will make sure you get the presentation. Thank you very much. Have a great day.